Good morning, students. This is your Jayashree ma'am. This is fifth standard maths class. So, as we have already discussed, already you have got two classes, right? So, in all two classes, we have already discussed about the place value, greater number, smaller number, greater than symbol, and less than symbol, equal sign, and how to write the numbers into words and words into numbers. So till now we have learned these things. Hope you have all understood what I have taught, right? So in today's class we are going to discuss about ascending order and descending order. So let me write on the board ascending order. And descending order. So what do you mean by ascending and descending? So ascending means, till now we have learned that ascending means small to big, right? That means it is from small to big. Right, children, ascending means small to big, and descending means big to small. Let us write few examples on ascending and descending. Example, let me give you single digit number. So for example, 9, 8, 7, 0, 3, 2. I don't want 0 here, I'll write 1, 3, 2. Okay. So in this ascending, we know that it's a small to big. So in this small to big, which is the smallest number? Yes, 1 is the smallest number. I have to write 1. Then which is the next smallest number? 2. Next, which is the next smallest number? 3. Then yes, 7, 8, and 9. So I have given you 6 numbers. These 6 numbers we have arranged in ascending order, that is small to big. Right, children? The same thing we go to descending order now. So descending order, I'll give you some numbers. For example, 1, 9, 6, 5, 8. So write this in descending order. That means arrange these things in descending order. So how to write in descending order? So descending order means big to small. So which is the bigger number here? 9 is the bigger number. So after 9, which is the bigger number? 8. After 8, which is the next bigger number? That is 6. After 6, which is the next biggest number? That is 5. After 5, that is 1. So now we have arranged these numbers in big to small. So these things are considered as descending order. Now, let me give you some big numbers. Arrange them in ascending as well as descending. First problem, 1389. Let us start from 2 digit. Now we have learnt single digit. Let us start from 2 digit. That is 13. 89, 23, and 57. So I have given you 4 numbers, that is 13, 89, 23, and 57. Using these numbers, we have to arrange them in ascending order as well as descending order. A means ascending order, D means descending order. Now arrange them, children. What do you mean by A? A tells you that it is small to big, right? Which is the smallest here? Yes, 13 is smallest. Then after 13, it comes 23. After 23, it comes 57. After 57, it comes 89. So all these things, it's in ascending order. Now let us discuss the descending order. Just now what I have written in ascending, you have to write just opposite to that. That is 89, 57, 23, 13. This is written in descending order. That means big to small. 89 is the bigger number and 13 is the smaller number. So we have arranged these numbers in both ascending and descending. Hope you have understood how to write ascending and descending in two digit. Now let us go for three digit number. Let me give you 100, 900, 700, 200. Arrange these numbers in ascending as well as descending. Arrange them, children. How we are going to get it? So arrange these numbers in ascending as well as descending. So how to arrange the ascending numbers from small to big? That is 100, 200, 700, 900. That is small to big. And descending. Descending is opposite of ascending. Greater number, bigger number to smaller number. 900, 700, 200, 100. Yes, children. So we have got both two digit and three digit in ascending and descending. Let me give you some higher numbers. How you are going to arrange them in ascending and descending? Let me see. So 3,817, 8,712, 5,021, 1,981. So I have given you four digit number which you have to arrange them in ascending as well as descending. So let me write A for ascending, B for descending. So which is the smallest number? We have to start with the smallest for ascending. So 1,981 is ascending, and next 3,817, 5,021, 8,712. So we have arranged these numbers in ascending order, that is small to big, and to the descending order, which is the greatest number? Yes, 8,712. Next 5,021. Next 3,817. Next 1,981. So even in the bigger number, we understood how to do the ascending as well as descending. Right, children? Do you remember in the last class I have made a list of greatest number and smallest number? How to arrange also I have showed you, right? Tell me now, which is the single digit greatest number? Which is the greatest number, children? Let me write on the board. Greatest single digit. Let us start from one digit. So which is the greatest one digit number? Yes, 9 is the greatest one digit number. Now just what I am going to do, I am going to add 1 for this greatest number, that is 9 plus 1. So what is 9 plus 1, children? What is 9 plus 1? 9 plus 1 is 10, right? So that is 10. So what is 9 plus 1? That is 10. So this, what is 10? You remember something in the last class we did? What we did? 10 is the, yes, 10 is the 2-digit smallest number. 10 is the smallest in 2-digit. So what we got? We started with 1-digit greatest number, that is 9, and we added plus 1. What we add? We added plus 1 and we got smallest 2-digit number. It's very easy, right, children? So let us go to the next greatest 2-digit number. What is the greatest 2-digit number? That is 99. Right, 2 times writing 9 which gives you greatest 2-digit number, that is 99. What I am going to do now? 99 plus 1, just I am going to add plus 1. So now what happens? 99 plus 1 is 100. So 100, what is it? It's a smallest number of, yes, it's the smallest number of 3 digits. So we got some wonder in the match also, right? We started with 1 digit, we ended with 2-digit smallest number. Again we started with 2-digit greater number, and again we got a 3-digit smallest number, and the same way it goes on. So if we take 3-digit, it is writing 3 times 9, 999, and I am going to add plus 1 for it, and what happened? It gave the answer 1000. What does it give? It gave the answer 1000, and 1000, how many digits are there? 1, 2, 3, 4 digits. So it became 4 digit number, right? Smallest 4 digit number. Let us go for 4 digits. So writing 9 4 times, 9999. Okay, so let me add plus 1 for it. It has become, how many zeros now? We have started with 4 digits, so 4 zeros with 1, and it gave us 5-digit smallest number. So your chapter name itself is 5-digit numbers. So 5-digit number, which is the smallest 5-digit number? 10,000. Once, remember the place value? In the first class itself we have discussed about the place value, right? Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000. So this is our 10,000, that is 5-digit number. Smallest 5-digit number is 10,000. So what is the next 5-digit? Let me write greatest 5-digit number also. That means writing 9 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 99,999. Keep one thing in your mind. Always when you are going to write the 1000 values, 1000 or 10,000 values, you have to put a comma. So when after 3 numbers, you have to put comma. 1, 2, 3. I have to put comma. 1, 2, 3. I have to put comma 1 2 3. Shall I put comma? No, because nothing is there here to put comma, right? If we have some other number behind it, we have to put commas. Okay, children. So after 99,999, we are going to add plus 1 for it. So this plus 1 makes us 100. How many zeros I have to put now? Yes, I am taking 5 digits. So how many zeros I have to put? 5 zeros. Yes. Now which number we got? We got 1 lakh. So how to do the place value 1 lakh? Ones, tens, hundreds, thousand, 10,000 and 1 lakh. Already we have discussed about the place value. Now you understood how to put commas also. You have to leave first 3 units, ones, tens and hundreds, and you have to put comma. Then after 1000 places, 1000 place, what are the 1000 place? 1000, 10,000. Next it starts the place value lakh. So this gives us smallest 6 digit number. So 1 lakh is the smallest 6 digit number. So from all these table we understood the smallest 5 digit and the greatest 5 digit number. What is the smallest 5 digit number? Yes, that is your 10,000. Right, children? What is the smallest 5 digit number? Your 10,000. So that is smallest number, then greatest. What is the 5 digit greatest number? Come to greatest column, 5 digit. What is this? Yes, 99,999. How you spell it, you have to write in the words also the same. Okay. So what is the greatest? 99,999. To make easier, write the 9 5 times. That itself gives you the greatest number, because we know that from 0 to 9, 1 is the smallest and 9 is the greatest. Why we are not writing 0? Yes, 0. If we write single, it does not has any value. With the number itself, the 0 has the value. Right, children? I hope today what and all we have discussed, we have understood. Today what we discussed? We discussed ascending order, descending order in 1 digit, 2 digit, 3 digit, 4 digit and 5 digit. Up to 5 digit number we did ascending as well as descending. What do you mean by ascending? Small to big is ascending, big to small is descending, right? Then today again we discussed about the greatest number and the smallest number. Using this greatest number, how we can get the next digit smallest number, isn't it, children? Just by adding plus 1 for the greatest numbers, we are going to get the next digit smallest numbers. So in this chapter, 5 digit number, you require smallest 5 digit number and greatest 5 digit number. What is the smallest 5 digit number? Yes, that is 10,000. What is the greatest 5 digit number? 99,999. So hope you have all understood. Today's homework will be in your textbook 5th standard part 1 page number 2. So till 6th May we have already done the homework in the last class, right? So remaining 7th May and 8th May. 7th May is write the following numbers in the ascending order, and 6th main write the following numbers in descending order. They have given you three questions. That is in four digits. So today itself we have discussed four digit and five digits in ascending and descending. That you have to write it down and send it to me in a WhatsApp assignment group. And you have to make a note of these two things. That is in page number four, below the table, you have last two points. That is 10,000 is the least five digit number. 99,999 is the greatest five digit number. And one more table I want you people to write on the classwork book itself. Wherever you are writing the homework, in that itself you have to write the classwork also. Okay, keep only one book for both the things. So this table should be written in the classwork. Page number 5, it's a greatest number having what we have discussed today's class. The same thing they have given in your table, in the textbook also, in the form of the table. This table should be written in the classwork. Okay, children. Hope you have all understood what I have explained. So meet you in the next class. Thank you, children. Be happy.